Michael Hellickson here with Club Wealth, and today we're talking about how to write a super strong offer. Check this formula out. Strong offers, right? If you want to write a strong offer, you got to know what to do. I'm going to show you in a minute here. SO times TA equals that right there. What is that? That's coffee, baby. And coffee is for closers. You guys know what I'm talking about. You know where that's from. Coffee really is for closers. Now, I'm a Mormon guy. You guys know that. But at the end of the day, maybe it's cocoa is for closers if it's me. But at the end of the day, you got to close to get the reward. If you don't close, you don't get the reward. And if you don't write a strong offer, you're not going to close very many transactions, particularly in a competitive market. So I'm going to rapid fire give you the things that you need to be thinking about. There's all kinds of additional things that are going to be in the download associated with this blog post. So make sure if you're watching this on YouTube, click on the link at the bottom of the video that'll take you to our website where the blog is. And on the blog, you'll have all kinds of extra stuff and you'll be able to download the checklist and all the things that you want to make sure you're doing on every one of your offers to ensure that it's a strong offer and you're going to be a successful closer. So what does SO times TA equal? SO is strong offer times tenacious agent. Yeah, that's you. Tenacious agent equals coffee, baby. All right, so let's talk about it. First of all, most of you are already doing this, but for those of you that aren't, make sure you type everything. I can't believe that in this day and age, there are still agents out there handwriting offers. That is insane to me. Never do that. It should always be typed. Next, why not start with the end in mind, right? If you want this thing to go together, what do you got to do? Ask the listing agent how they want it written up and then do it. If the listing agent says write it up in XYZ way, guess what you do? You write it up in XYZ way. Why? Because they're going to like your offer over other offers because you've done exactly what they've asked you to do. Next, minimize contingencies. This goes without saying, but you want to minimize or completely eliminate any contingencies you possibly can. Get a pre-approval letter, check this out, subject only to appraisal and clear title. Make sure there's no other contingencies in your approval letter. Now, you want to take this to the next level? Get a pre-approval letter from the lender that the listing agent uses. Think about that one for just a moment. Let that settle in. If you get a pre-approval letter from the lender that the listing agent uses, again, you've got them at ease. You've got them feeling like, okay, these guys really are qualified. Next, high earnest money, 5% or better if possible. Also, if you really want to go to the next level, and if your buyers are comfortable with it, make sure you check with your broker on this and all of the other things we're talking about in this video. But assuming your buyer is comfortable with it, make the earnest money non-refundable and equal to the down payment. If they're serious about this house, let's get some skin in the game. That's what listing agents want to see. Also, no inspection contingencies. Get rid of them. Do the inspection pre-offer if you can. Or don't do an inspection at all if you're brave enough and your clients are feeling comfortable enough to do that. Be careful again with this. Check with your broker and make sure that you and your buyers know what the priority is. Escalation clause. Always include an escalation clause if necessary, if you know you're going to be in a multiple offer situation. Proof of funds with offer. If you're not going to do all of the money for the down payment or for the earnest money, if you're not going to have the earnest money equal the down payment, then at the very least include proof of funds, bank statements or something showing that they actually have all the money they're going to need to close this transaction, and ideally even more. All right. How about this? A daily delayed closing penalty. In other words, if your buyer causes a delay in closing, write in a penalty. Maybe it's $50 or $100 or $250 per day penalty for every day they go beyond the closing date. You want to talk about a strong offer? That's writing a strong offer. Now, here's a super creative idea, not for the faint of heart. Got to make sure your broker's okay with it and got to make sure that this is compliant with your lender's guidelines. But check it out. What if you said, okay, we're going to sign a buyer agency agreement with our buyer and we're going to have the buyer be responsible for our commission post-closing. So in other words, the commission that the seller had actually set aside for the selling office commission, we're going to give that back to the seller. instead of us taking that in commission. And then the buyer's going to pay us either immediately or over time post-closing, in addition to whatever is going on inside the transaction. Again, you got to document the heck out of this. Make sure you're RESPA and HUD compliant, and make sure that you're lender compliant as well. Make sure your broker's involved in that one. But a great strategy in a multiple offer scenario, particularly where you know you may have appraisal issues, that's a very good strategy to use. How about a short closing time frame? Sellers love to see a short seller closing time frame. Again, double check with that listing agent on when they want that closing date to be, and then make that closing date happen. You may have a seller that says, look, I want it to close now, and I want to extend the occupancy, so the seller wants to stay in and occupy the property post-closing so that they can have time to, you know, move into their new place or whatever. Whenever and wherever possible, accommodate the seller's desires. It's easiest to do that if you know what they are because you've chatted with the listing agent. All right. How about the letter from the buyer to the seller? This is a very popular practice, especially in California. Other parts of the country are catching on to this as well. Again, as with most personal notes, let's keep it to 3 to 5 lines. Blue ink, broad tip pen if you've got one. Include where appropriate and where productive a photo of the family. Mention the home, why it's a perfect fit for them. If you can, try and notice something interesting about the home. I had one time where the seller had clearly done a really interesting architectural picket fence out front. It really wasn't just a picket fence. It was like they had, you know, little boards going 10 different ways to Sundays. It was obviously custom done by the seller. And, you know, he was also a mechanic, had been working in his garage, done a bunch of stuff in there. So we brought that up so we could kind of suck him in. You know, the buyers mentioned, man, I love that picket fence you did out front. And, man, the shop that you put together is such a great shop. I can't wait to get in there and work on my El Camino or whatever it was. Then on that same house, here was the kicker. On that same house, we noticed how on the trim by the pantry door, what had they been doing? They'd been putting the little marks all along on that trim as the kids were growing up. They'd put a mark and a date by and the kid's name as they were getting taller throughout the years. So here's what we did. This is almost unfair. I shouldn't tell you about this because it's almost an unfair advantage. But literally we wrote right in the letter, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, we would understand if you want to take that piece of trim with you, because if it was our kids, we'd want to take it with us as well. So feel free to take that piece of trim with you when you move. And let me tell you, we got that house, and I am convinced it was because of that one thing that we got that house. And there were like 10 or 11 other offers. I can't remember how many. And by the way, one of those offers was from the listing agent. And let me tell you, she was fired up mad because my buyers got it and her buyers didn't. Anyway, crazy story, true story, absolutely something you can use. All right, then I want to include an executive summary to the listing agent of the offer. So I want to include, here's the price, here's any contingencies, if any, here's the inspection time frame if there is one, here's our financing details, down payment, pre-qual letter, are we pre-approved, etc. So I want to just include a little very short on one piece of paper, 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, a very concise executive summary, including those things as a cover letter to the listing agent to make it really easy for them to understand what they're about to see inside that offer. Again, you guys, make the listing agent's job as easy as possible. Make sure you paint the listing agent as a rock star. Edify them in front of their sellers. In the letter to the sellers, you might write something like, you guys did a great job picking your listing agent. You know, Susie's fantastic. We have always heard great things about her. Or I had another transaction with her. She did a fantastic job. Whatever. Never underestimate the power of a good word. Folks, I hope this has been helpful to you. Don't forget to click down below or on the side, wherever it happens to be on this page. You will see the opt-in so that you can get the download, the actual checklist that you want to follow when you're writing your offers. Also, at the bottom of the page, all the way at the bottom, you'll see a spot to request a strategy session from a Club Wealth coach. Let me just tell you about this real quick. Most coaching companies, when they offer you a strategy session, it's really a sales pitch. That's not us. That's not what we do. What I want you to do is I want you to click on that. We're going to give you 55 minutes of our time. We're going to give it to you with a coach that's appropriate for your production level. So the coach that works in that production level on a daily basis. We're going to have them analyze your business. We're going to have them analyze what's working for you, what's not working for you, what you've tried, what you haven't tried, what you will and will not be willing to do, where you want to go, where you're at today, and we're going to give you a roadmap on how to get there. Then, at the end of your 55-minute call with your coach, should you want more information about coaching, feel free to ask, and at that time, we'll be happy to tell you. But that 55-minute coaching session is all about bringing value to you and helping you get from where you are today to where you want to be down the road. You have my word on it. Please fill out that strategy session request form at the bottom of the page. My name again is Michael Hellickson. I'm with Club Wealth. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I hope you enjoy the videos that we put out. I hope they're helpful to you. And I welcome your comments and requests for additional types of videos. And just tell me how you feel. What's working well for you? What's not working? What would you like to see more of, less of? Put it in the comments at the bottom of this post and we'll be sure and respond. I personally respond to each and every comment that people put on our blog post. So please reach out to us. And finally, in closing, if you haven't done so already, check out our Facebook Mastermind group at facebook.com/. Actually, I don't know what the URL is, but it's the Club Wealth Real Estate Agent Mastermind. The Club Wealth Real Estate Agent Mastermind on Facebook. We got at the time this video was done, we had thousands of members already. It's a very refined group. Great agents in that group. We're very careful to keep the discussion positive, on point, and very educational. So have an awesome day. Remember, you are world class.